गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी प्रूव्ड सम थ्योरम बेस्ड ऑन पैरेललोग्राम लाइक दैट। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू शो इट आर डायगोनल्स ऑफ अ पैरेललोग्राम डिवाइड इट इनटू टू कॉन्ग्रुएंट ट्रायंगल्स। सेकंड थ्योरम इज रिलेटेड टू पैरेललोग्राम इज इन अ पैरेललोग्राम अपोजिट साइड्स आर इक्वल। ओके, टू रिजल्ट्स, two theorems proved related to parallelogram. Now we take some other another theorem based on parallelogram. Take a theorem, the opposite angles angles of a parallelogram are equal this is your theorem, the opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Okay, now proved it. First of all you write given na In given we write, first of all we write a parallelogram ABCD. Okay, first of all we write a parallelogram ABCD. Now that first of all we take a parallelogram C and D. Okay, we have to show it the opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal, that is angle C is equal to angle A is equal to angle C and angle B is equal to angle D. These are the opposite angles, and why we have to show that the opposite angles of a quadrilateral parallelogram are equal. Now we write to prove what I am prove. Opposite angles are equal, that is angle A is equal to angle C and angle B is equal to angle D. We have to show that angle A is equal to angle C and angle B is equal to angle D. Okay, now let's prove it. Now in this diagram there is not to do any constructions. Okay, now proof. You know that in parallelogram opposite sides are parallel to each other. In any parallelogram opposite sides are parallel to each other na, that is AB parallel to CD and AD parallel to BC. So you write here, we know that in parallelogram ABCD, AB parallel to CD and BC parallel to AD, that is AB parallel to CD and AD parallel to BC. Okay, now first of all we take AB parallel to CD and AD as a transversal. Okay, now we take AB parallel to CD, and AD as a transversal, and AD as a transversal. Okay, then we know that the sum of the consecutive interior angles are supplementary to each other. Suppose if we have AB parallel to CD, then angle A and angle D are formed by supplementary angles, so their sum of measures is 180. Okay, now AB parallel to CD and AD as a transversal, then angle A plus angle D is equal to 180 because of the sum of consecutive interior angle is 180. The sum of consecutive interior angles is 180. Okay. Now again, we take AD parallel to BC and CD as a transversal. Now again from take equation 1, again from figure, let's see AD parallel to BC and CD as a transversal and CD as the CD as the transversal. Transversal. Then again, angle C plus angle D is 180. Take equation number 2. Now, from equation 1 and 2, we get 180, 180, so they are equal to each other. Angle A plus angle D is equal to angle C plus angle D. Angle D are cancelled to each other. So we have angle A is equal to angle C. Okay. Similarly we have to prove it. Angle B is equal to angle D. Similarly, we have to prove it. Angle B is equal to angle D. Hence, in parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. Proved. Okay. So, dear student, in this way you proved that type of results. Let's see once more time. Your theorem is the opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Okay. So, first of all, you write given, you form a parallelogram ABCD here like that. ABCD is a parallelogram in which opposite angles are equal. We have to prove it, that is angle A is equal to angle C and angle B is equal to angle D. Okay. And we know that in any parallelogram the opposite sides are parallel to each other. First of all, we take AB parallel to CD and AD as a transversal. So these are the pair of consecutive interior angles, angle A and angle D. And you know that the consecutive interior angles are supplementary to each other, so their sum of measures is 180. In this way we write angle A plus angle D is equal to 180. Similarly, again from figure we take BC parallel to AD and CD as a transversal. Then again angle C and angle D form a alternate, so a consecutive interior angle. So their sum of measures also 180. Okay, so angle C is equal to angle C plus angle D also 180. Now from equation 1 and 2, both are equal to each other because of each equal to 180. So from 1 and 2 we get angle A plus angle D is equal to angle C plus angle D. So angle D and angle D cancel to each other and you get angle A is equal to angle C. Okay. Similarly, we have to prove it, angle B is equal to angle D. Hence, we can say that in any parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. Proved. Okay, this is very important theorem. Now, we take some other theorem based on parallelogram. Let's see. Your next theorem is the the diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. Diagonals of a parallelogram of a parallelogram bisect each other. Okay, this is the next theorem. The diagonal of a parallelogram bisect to each other. Okay, now let's prove. First of all, you write given. First of all, we write given. Okay, you draw a parallelogram. A, B, C, D, and draw its diagonal A, C and B, D, which are intersect at point O. So, first of all, you write in given a parallelogram A, B, C, D in which A, C and B, D AC and BD are diagonals. BD are diagonals which are intersect. Intersects at point O. In that point, okay, and we have to prove it. To prove according to theorem, we have to prove it. The diagonals of a parallelogram bisects each other. It means that diagonal bisects means that OA is equal to OC and OB is equal to OD. Okay, OA is equal to OC and OD is equal to OB. That is, O is the midpoint of diagonal AC and also O is also the midpoint of diagonal BD. Okay, that is, O is equal to OC and OB is equal to OD. This is proved it. Okay, now we write proof and prove it. You know that in any parallelogram, AB parallel, opposite sides are parallel to each other. AB parallel to CD and BC parallel to AD. Okay, now first we take AB parallel to CD and AC as a transversal. Okay, now from figure, let's see. AB parallel to CD and AC as a transversal. Then you know that alternate interior angles are equal, that is angle BAC, that angle, and angle DCA are equal to each other. That is, then angle BAC is equal to angle BAC is equal to angle DCA. Angle DCA OR, this implies that angle BAC, we write angle BAO. Angle BAO is equal to angle DCO. Angle DCO. These are the alternate interior angles. Okay. Now again, ए बी पैरेलल टू सी डी एंड टेक डी डी एज अ ट्रांसवर्सल. नाउ अगेन नो अगेन ए बी पैरेलल टू सी डी एंड नाउ टेक बी डी एज अ ट्रांसवर्सल एंड बी डी एज अ ट्रांसवर्सल. देन अगेन अल्टरनेट इंटीरियर एंगल आर इक्वल, दैट इज एंगल ए बी ओ इज इक्वल टू एंगल सी डी ओ. ओके दिस एंगल इज इक्वल टू दिस एंगल. देन एंगल ए बी ओ, एंगल ए बी ओ इज इक्वल टू एंगल सी डी ओ, एंगल सी डी ओ. दीज आर ऑल्सो द अल्टरनेट इंटीरियर एंगल्स. ओके नाउ इन ट्राइंगल ए ओ बी एंड सी ओ डी. ओके नाउ इन ट्राइंगल ए ओ बी, इन ट्राइंगल्स ए ओ बी एंड ट्राइंगल सी ओ डी, इन ट्राइंगल सी ओ डी वी हैव वाट हैव एंगल बी ए ओ, एंगल बी ए ओ इज इक्वल टू एंगल डी सी ओ फ्रॉम इक्वेशन वन. बी ए ओ इज इक्वल टू डी सी ओ दैट एंगल एंड ए बी ओ एंड वेट ए बी इज इक्वल टू सी डी ना, अपोजिट साइड्स ऑफ पैरेललोग्राम आर इक्वल. ए बी इज इक्वल टू सी डी, ए बी इज इक्वल टू सी डी, दिस इज द अपोजिट साइड्स ऑफ अ पैरेललोग्राम आर इक्वल. ओके एंड एंगल ए बी ओ इज इक्वल टू एंगल सी डी ओ फ्रॉम टू, एंगल ए बी ओ इज इक्वल टू एंगल सी डी ओ, दिस इज फ्रॉम इक्वेशन वन एंड दिस इज फ्रॉम इक्वेशन टू. ओके सो बाई एंगल साइड एंगल कॉन्ग्रुएंस क्राइटेरियन, सो बाई एंगल साइड एंगल कॉन्ग्रुएंस क्राइटेरियन ट्रायंगल ए ओ बी कॉन्ग्रुएंस टू ट्रायंगल सी ओ डी. ओके देन बाय सी पी सी टी, देन बाय सी पी सी टी, व्हाट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ फुल फॉर्म ऑफ सी पी सी टी, कॉन्ग्रुएंट पार्ट ऑफ करस्पॉन्डिंग पार्ट ऑफ कॉन्ग्रुएंट ट्रायंगल. ओके वी गेट व्हाट गेट, ओ ए इज इक्वल टू ओ सी. ओके ओ ए इज इक्वल टू ओ सी एंड आल्सो ओ बी इज इक्वल टू ओ डी एंड ओ बी इज इक्वल टू ओ डी. हैंस वी कैन से दैट द डायगोनल्स ऑफ अ पैरेललोग्राम बाइसेक्ट्स ईच अदर, बाइसेक्ट्स ईच अदर. हैंस प्रूफ, हैंस प्रूफ. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वे वी प्रूव द ऑल द थ्योरम बेस्ड ऑन parallelogram. Okay, we have to prove four theorem related to parallelogram. The opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal, the diagonals of a parallelogram bisects each other, and the diagonals of the parallelogram divides into two congruent triangles, and the parallelogram opposite sides are equal. So from the above discussion we have 1 minute. Thus, from the above discussion, we have in a parallelogram first result is that what diagonals divide it into two congruent triangles. First result is diagonal divide it into congruent triangles. Okay. Second important result is that what opposite sides are equal. Opposite sides are equal. Hence, we can say that in a parallelogram, opposite sides are parallel to each other as well as equal to each other. Okay? Yes. Third important result we have to prove in previous theorem, opposite angles are equal. Angles are equal. And fourth one, diagonals bisects each other. Diagonal bisects each other. Diagonal bisects each other. Okay. In this way, we solve some questions of parallelogram based on these concepts. So that point also remember, in any parallelogram, diagonals divide it into two congruent triangles. Opposite sides are equal, opposite angles are equal, diagonals bisects each other. Okay. Let take some example based on parallelogram. Let's see. Take a question. In the given figure, ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. Compute the values of x and y. Compute the values of x and y. Your figure is A, B, C, D. This is your figure, and BD is a diagonal that is 12x, that is 7y, that is 28 degree, and that is 60 degree. Okay. Now solve it. In we know that, first of all you write, we know that in a parallelogram ABCD, the opposite sides are parallel to each other, opposite sides are parallel. So from figure, BC parallel to AD, BC parallel to AD na, okay, that is AD parallel to BC, and BD as a transversal. From figure, BC parallel to AD and BD as a transversal, and BD as a transversal, BC parallel to AD and BD as a transversal, then we know the alternate interior angle are equal to each other, na, that then angle DBC, is equal to angle ADB, that is angle DBC is equal to 7y, and angle ADB is equal to 28. So the value of y is equal to 28 upon 7, 7 4 that is y is equal to 4. This is one answer. Again from figure, AB parallel to BC parallel to AD and BD as a transversal, then ABD, angle ABD is equal to BD is equal to angle BDC, both are the alternate interior angles. These are also the alternate interior angles. So we have angle ABD is 12x, and angle BDC is 60. So the value of x is equal to 60 upon 12 here is a 60, that is 5. So thus the value of x is 5 and the value of 4 y is 4. This is your answer. Okay, so dear students, you solve, first of all you remember these points of a parallelogram and practice the theorem which we proved in a previous class, previous topic, and then after you solve the question based on parallelogram like that. Okay, this is a question based on parallelogram, na? So in this way you solve all the questions of your NCERT exercise based on parallelogram and practice all the theorem based on parallelogram, and that point is to be remember. Okay, in this way we solve the questions. So dear students, you complete all the questions of your NCERT exercise based on parallelogram. Okay, thank you.